Massachusetts has set a goal of attaining net zero emissions by the year 2050. To meet that objective, the state is banking on a big jolt of hydroelectric power imported from Canada. If passed, a proposal to partner with Hydro-Québec and run transmission lines from the giant dams in Quebec down through Maine would become New England's largest renewable energy project.
Then there is small, low-impact hydro, privately owned, a cottage industry of sorts. Think of it as mom-and-pop electric shops.
I worked with my dad summers, really, at the first turbine I got into, I was about 10 years old.
Perhaps you think of hydroelectric dams as the sole province of municipalities, state entities, and big utility companies. Well, sometimes, maybe, but they can also belong to guys like Luke Wright.
Yeah, I own the dam, and it makes hydropower. Clean energy.
Luke's father bought this dam in the town of Barrie about 40 years ago. It came with a defunct powerhouse, which they got up and running again.
All the equipment that you see here functioning is 1920s vintage equipment. It's about the same vintage as a Model T.
Indeed, the technology, as it were, is vintage Frankenstein era. Still, it's good enough to power plenty of iPhones.
If you want to put it in terms of like tons of coal, we're somewhere around the displacement of 2,000 tons of coal out of this power plant. So that's a lot of emission we've managed to actually keep out of the air.
Today, Wright's company, Ware River Power, owns a handful of small dams in central Mass. He thinks the state's push to remove obsolete dams is fine, but he worries that the clean energy benefits of working dams like his are getting lost in the churn.
This water that we're using here will go eventually to the Connecticut, but goes over and through and produces energy at 12 different dams from here down to the Connecticut. So if that's not renewable, what is? I mean, the same water being used over and over and over and over again. I love what I do. That feeling that, okay, at the end of the day, my carbon footprint is so negative, right? Who doesn't want a negative carbon footprint?
The Wrights may have gotten their dam to work, but Henry Ford had a harder time with his.
This is Ford's Folly. It's a dam that was built in 1930 by Henry Ford.
Hidden in the woods of Sudbury, a strange and unexpected sight. A towering wall of stone straight out of Game of Thrones. Aline Kaplan and Sudbury town historian Jan Hardenberg are our guides.
You might be tempted to wonder why it's here.
Auto titan Henry Ford bought the nearby Wayside Inn in the 1920s with a vision of recreating a traditional New England village. He built the Martha Mary Chapel and a traditional gristmill that operates to this day. Ford also decided his village needed a reservoir, so he built this massive dam on nearby Knobscot Hill to capture the water of Hop Brook.
It should have worked. It didn't.
Turns out the underlying bedrock is porous here. The reservoir would fill up, then the water would leak out. Ford refused to admit defeat.
For 16 years, from 1930 to 1946, they tried to make this dam work. There is a huge block of concrete right down there. Hop Brook ran right underneath it. I'm assuming if we put another block of concrete, Hop Brook would run right underneath that as well.
On Ford's death, the dam was abandoned. Its only use, an occasional launch pad for junk cars.
Because the teenage boys here in Sudbury used to push cars off the dam for fun.
Over time, this archaeological oddity has come to be known as Ford's Folly, a hulking, humbling reminder of the limit of man's control over nature.
And look, a tiny little brook defeated him.
And back to South Barrie, Luke Wright thinks that small, low-power hydro dams aren't actually getting the love they deserve from the state.
Well, partly that's because of the big bet on Canadian hydropower. That's part of it. But also, Luke says that his power at his dam, he gets paid 8 cents per kilowatt hour. But just down the road, there's a solar field that's subsidized that gets 25 to 30 cents per kilowatt hour. So he feels like he's kind of behind the eight ball.
Yeah, that's the difference. All right, today, this river is beautiful. Before the dam removal, a different description.